Okay, we've got a pretty huge cane toad in here.
Expert toad hunter Emily Vincent from the environmental charity Watergum spends her days...
Got it.
...and quite a few of her nights in hot pursuit of a cold-blooded adversary.
Got him!
She has a healthy respect for this cranky critter, warts and all.
I always have this kind of angry expression. And I have to say, that expression kind of endears me. It's like a kind of grumpy granddad, you know? They're taking over continents and they're still pretty grumpy about it, despite all their success.
On a perfect night for toad busting, Emily and an army of volunteers are on a catch and freeze mission at David Flay Wildlife Park on the Gold Coast. It's billed as a bit of family fun.
Lucky daughter. Bonding.
Cathy Scott has caught hundreds, but this is Gemma's first toadio.
I'm scared. They're terrifying. But it should be fun.
Social toad-busting events, complete with sausage sizzles, have become an annual fixture in the ever-expanding kingdom of the cane toad. 102 were introduced to Queensland in 1935 to control sugarcane beetles.
Any foreign creature you bring in could upset the environmental balance.
Oh.
The rest, as they say, is history. Three states and the NT are now occupied territory.
Hey, look, those frogs are eating all their crops!
Oh, it's our state icon. It's the pest of all pests, but we've grown to love it and hate it, and it's a love-hate relationship.
Queensland Parks and Wildlife Ranger Miles Pritchett moonlighted on MasterChef a few years ago.
You're my mate with a cool haircut.
Tonight he's cooking the snags and encouraging toad busters to fill their buckets.
Oh, I can't stand them because the biggest factor for me is that they destroy habitat and frog species and they kill all our native wildlife. Snakes that bite them die. I despise cane toads with a passion.
But even Miles had to admire this big girl, a titanic toad discovered in North Queensland recently by a fellow ranger.
A park ranger in Australia stumbled upon this enormous cane toad.
And they're calling it Toadzilla.
It's a surprise, everyone. It's a beast. That toad was over 2.5 kilos. You know, it's a monster.
I send that to all my friends. I said, I need a bigger bucket to catch that one.
The first thing that I noticed and zeroed in on were those huge parotid glands. All I could think of is how much toxin is in those glands. It's the only thing I could look at.
Dr. Andrew Amy was also impressed. He wants to put Toadzilla on display at the Queensland Museum. She'll join two other plus-sized toads in his collection.
This guy is yuck.
And he's not just talking about her looks.
The yuck's name came spontaneously.
And these are all that remains of a bigger toad called Betty Davis. She was a pet of a former curator.
Betty Davis, Glenn, the curator, actually thought she had beautiful eyes.
She's got Betty Davis eyes.
So that was her name.
But the new star is Toadzilla, who will be made into a plaster cast and become the biggest cane toad in the collection.
They've proven their adaptability and their resilience, that they can survive just about anywhere. You've got to admire that.
No one really knows how many cane toads there are now, but the best estimate is about 200 million. Even more alarming is the science that shows toads on the front line of the invasion are evolving to be faster, stronger and fitter.
Their legs are now much longer than they used to be. Their bodies are much smaller. They can hop further and with more vigour.
So the invasion front is actually moving and they're actually invading faster as they go along.
In fact, the new improved cane toads are claiming territory at a rate of 50 kilometres a year, five times faster than when the invasion began. Extreme weather events are also accelerating the spread. Cane toads thrive in floods and can cover more territory after fires.
These climate disasters that we're experiencing are unfortunately great for the toad.
But there is hope that science and nature will turn the tables. A few days ago, the conservation team at Watergum took delivery of a new weapon.
The tadpoles just find it irresistible to go in there.
These traps were developed at Queensland University. They use cane toad poison to mimic the scent of cane toad eggs.
Cane toad tadpoles, as soon as they hatch, they first seek out the eggs of other cane toads to eat them. So they're cannibalistic.
Great catch.
This trap was set 7 hours ago. One female can lay 70,000 eggs in a year, but this gets them before they have a chance to cause too much damage.
The same female laid all of these tadpoles.
Our native animals are also getting in on the action, and it could be a game changer. More and more of them are working out how to eat around the poisoned glands, turning toads into tucker. Crows go for the stomach.
They actually feast on the insects within the toad's stomach and they kill it in the process.
The much maligned bin chicken has come up with an ingenious cane toad hack, tossing a toad around until it excretes its poison.
Ibis then just take them down to the creek and wash them. They wash off all that toxin, swallow them whole, and they're fine.
Which gives our wildlife ranger and part-time chef a light bulb moment.
If there was a way that they could be cooked and eaten, I'd give it a crack for sure. You know, what better way to get them out of the system than having people picking them up and taking them home for a fry-up? You know, teriyaki toad, who wouldn't thrive on that, you know?
Squeeze hard.
In the meantime, new toad-busting recruits like Gemma...
This is how you do it. Learn from mother.
..are desperately needed to keep numbers down.
How's that feel?
It's definitely a mission accomplished when you catch them.
But to catch them all, well, that's a mission impossible.
I don't think it's the humans that are going to win the battle against cane toads. It's going to be the native species. One day, we are all going to coexist happily together.
They're not great for wildlife, but also not good for pets. When I was living in Queensland, my dog would lick the backs of toads. You know, the toxins?
Oh, yes.
It's almost like a hallucinogen.
No.
What? Yeah, so
the dog
would
get high.
From the toads. I'd find her, like, in the backyard, splayed out, pupils dilated, listening to Pink Floyd. Like, it was insane. But they're so dangerous, and there's nothing good about them.
Would it be different if they were good-looking?
No.
Yes, it would.
I think it would be.
Yeah, it would be.
They kill a lot of vegetarian, but they're so cute.
If they were beautiful and had pretty feathers or...
Everyone's being nice to Toadzilla. The body positivity movements, you know, extended to the...
I know, we love an exception. Like, you like the world record giant toad.
Oh, of course.
But just in Queensland, coming home at night, and they just be on that. They're hideous.
Do you think maybe we get some bigger toads in to eat those toads? That would be a good idea, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Yes.
I can't see that failing.
No. That's a great idea.
You're welcome, Australia.